Nossa.
How are you?
I'm going good, yourself, sir?
I'm all right. How are you feeling?
Like the underdog, get it? Because I'm playing Necro.
Oh, very nice. I like that.
Thank you. Thank you. Ah, look, what's he got? Agility 5 fucking vampire.
Yeah, ugh. just looking at him now. But everybody's got to love an underdog.
Oh, they do. They do. Free block. Yeah, he's gone just as well as I have with skill ups.
He's, I think you're going to have a bit of inducement money. Might be, I think it's about 90k.
1320 to 1150, but I'm missing players, aren't I?
You're missing two players, so that's an extra 80.
80.
So it brings you up to 1230.
Yep. But I've got 100k sitting 30, in cash.
30, 20, that's 90, yeah. So, you got a decision to make, my friend.
He has to go first, so he can't benefit from any money I spend, can he?
I don't know.
I don't think
no.
he can.
No, he can't.
No, I got screwed over in Show Pony for that.
I think that's right.
Yeah.
But do you really want to
delete this team after this game? Yes.
I was going to say two loner zombies. I guess zombies aren't too bad as loners, actually.
Well, considering their agility too, they don't dodge anyway.
Yeah. They're just little annoying roadblocks, aren't they?
Yeah, but it's not worth it. I can buy a wizard. If I chuck my own cash in.
Ooh, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it here first.
I can, but my knockout rerolls are horrible, so I might buy three babes just to get my players back, since Hedgehog has the nasty habit of beating up my teams.
I think you can only get two. Is that right?
I'll buy them. That's fine.
Yeah, a couple of babes. One for each arm.
Otherwise, what's that, so I only got about 150, 180, isn't it? I can't really buy a star player unless...
Unless...
He comes with a chainsaw. That does sound like a hell of a lot more fun, to be honest.
Yeah, he's got a couple of dodge pieces. You've got one tackle white, chainsaw... Of course, doesn't give a shit about strength 4.
Nah.
So, could be handy.
Could be damn fun, to be honest.
Just watch out for those hypnotic homosexuals, is all I'm going to say. I loved your meme. That's so good.
Yep, I've been talking to myself,
Do
activate
not
your
it.
Players.
Activate.
Activate first, so we'll see how we go about.
Just looking at the two teams' track records, he's slightly better than you with 2 wins, 2 draws, 2 losses. I think you've got 3 wins, 4 losses, something like that.
Yeah, I got all losses in the one win and all losses in the regular season.
And then you got your wins in the playoffs.
In the quarter and semi, I've been very fortunate to have my team actually do stuff.
Oh, let's see if you can keep that run going, eh?
5-2. Should be interesting.
Have you won a trophy in the Auctiania Blood Bowl League yet?
No. So this is only my second season. I'm actually I'm still a newbie.
Yeah,
I only came in at the end of last season.
How quickly we forget.
Indeed.
Mate,
but since then,
this could be it. This could be the start of many to
come. Got to start somewhere. But this is my second season, second finals that I've made.
Nice.
So I think I made semis in the Show Pony.
Yeah. Who were you last cycle? What team?
So I was playing my Chaos Dwarves.
Yeah.
And that's the game where I couldn't pick up the ball in 3 turns on 5 attempts.
Ah, fuck, that's right.
That was Blood Bowl at its greatest.
Well, You're in the grand final tonight, my friend.
Oop, Hedgehog looks like he's just sent me a message.
Very good, very good. We like to see that.
He's told me to go fuck myself and he's going to hold the thing from my corpse.
He's going he's going to drink your blood.
Yeah.
Are you going to be chatting with your opponent during the game?
Yeah, so I'll probably send him an invite. I'll probably pop out in about 2 minutes. And because we actually played each other 2 nights ago.
Oh, yeah.
In the Deaf and Human Pestilence tournament.
Yeah, yeah.
So he was taking Kislev versus my Nurgle.
I think I saw a little bit of that.
We had no idea what we were doing.
But I think you scraped a victory, did you not?
I did. I went 3-0 in the tournament with Nurgs.
Yeah, very nice. You got to be pleased with that, mate.
I was, actually. They're an interesting team. I still think that even at 1500, they're not developed, which is weird.
And once again, if you're watching or if you watch this back, Luke Stewart, thank you so much for organising that little side tournament.
Absolutely. It kept me sane for the Easter break.
Yeah, but I think I probably should have joined in.
Yeah, mate, those 2 hours away from my kids and family.
It's gold.
I'm just like, Daddy needs 2 hours.
Yeah, you have to treasure it, eh?
Just let me have this, I'll do everything else.
What a nightmare.
So he hasn't jumped on. As soon as he jumps online, I'll jump off.
All right, no worries at all.
When's the sloppy seconds?
So I haven't been told when the sloppy seconds is yet. Friday night. That's right. Friday night. The big show. So it'd be nice hopefully if sloppy seconds get their shit together and
coming on Thursday night would be good.
Who is in that sloppy seconds final? I'm pretty sure it's Planting Lemur.
It's Lizards and it's Chaos Dwarves versus Cidric.
Oh, it's Cidric.
Yeah, Cidric with his woodies.
Planting Lemur versus Cidric.
Chaos Dwarves versus Wood Elves. So good luck, Cidric. I'm gonna bugger off. I've got an emotional vampire online.
Good luck for the game, JK.
Thank you very much.
Talk to you after the game.
See you later.
Yeah, mate.
See you, man.
Hey, goodbye. And there he goes. So, as you may or may not have gathered, Blood Bowl fans, this is
place for another one.
Hello, how are you? Are you ready?
Oh, Java invited me, so yes, sorry, I'm going to leave you.
You have to go and drink some blood.
Why are you doing this better?
Just quickly, how are you feeling?
I'm going to be ruined, that's how.
Well, good luck for the game, and I will talk to you afterwards, mate.
Cool, thanks, yeah, see you.
see ya, bye. Bye.
Wait a second, and bye.
Okay, goodbye. So that is both coaches, the pre-game interview completed. Hedgehog, Emotional Vampires versus Jawa Knight, doing it doggy style all night long. competitors in the Season 7 Don't Even Bother Bowl. Why they're bothering, I don't know. But they are. Which is good. Because otherwise, we'd just be sitting here playing with our dicks. So hopefully not too far away from kick off. Hoping somebody at some stage will come to my rescue and join me in the commentary booth. Doesn't appear to be many takers at this stage. Planting Lima is saying he is watching, but can't get to his PlayStation, frowny face, so it's no good. Right, let's have a quick squiz. No game yet. For anybody who is watching, who is not familiar with what the fuck is going on, this is an online Blood Bowl league via the PlayStation console format. We try and restrict players in the league to those that are in the Oceania time zone, Australia predominantly, New Zealand, parts of Asia are incorporated also. We have coaches in Hong Kong and Japan and Western Australia, which may as well be fucking Hong Kong and Japan. It's that fucking far away. So, if you are in that region of the globe and would like a friendly league to test your skills in, or even if you're brand new and you like the look of the game and want to learn a bit more, have a look at us. I think you can find us on Facebook somewhere. Rummage around in Discord. We've got a Discord channel. Yeah. And come on in. It's great fun. And here we go. We've got a game. Did you know? Blah, 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 blah. Chaos God's idea of a great reward. Blah, 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 blah. And then crushed to death as the Hobgoblin team stadium, along with 30,000 fans, collapsed on his writhing body. Oh, okay. Vampires setting up first. What did Jarwinite do for his inducements? He has one babe and one wizard. Ooh! Looks like the emotional vampires were also able to purchase a babe and bring her to the game. Can't see her on the sidelines anywhere. I'm sure she's pretty smoking, those vampire babes normally are. The weather is nice at this stage, and neither coach has plus fame. So, Jawa Knight has decided to go with the two journeyman zombies, 11 players. 11 players also for the vampires, 5 vamps and 6 thralls. Let's see how long those thralls last, eh? We have a blodging werewolf on the necro team, a tackle white, a block flesh golem, Gary Glitter loves it up the shitter. Oh, And is that a Blodge Surehands Ghoul? Harvey Weinstein, it is. Jawa Knight just finalizing his attacking setup. On the vampire side, we have one block vampire, one dodge vampire, one blodge vampire, and one block agility 5 vampire. Ooh, your wife's stupid BFF. That's a player to look out for. I predict he bloodlusts turn one and gets sent off. Here we go. Grand final. Don't even bother bowl. Perfect defense. That's a very fucking shallow kick. It's going straight to shit cunt. The rookie werewolf. I don't fancy his chances of catching that, but you never know. I think Jawa Knight will be hoping for a touchback here. Or at the very least, a fumbled catch with the ball dropping just behind that attacking line. I apologise. I did have my Twitch chat open on my phone, but unfortunately it wasn't able to pick up on that comment that somebody just made. So, as always, if you'd like to comment again, I'll be able to fucking read it if you feel like it. If not, fine. Fuck you. There we go. Oh, hello, Lima. Go fucking OBBL finals. 100%, bro. That is all. We do enjoy this league. As Jawa Knight was saying pre-game, it pretty much keeps us all sane. Oh, yep, fumbled. And there we go. Ball just drops behind the attacking line. That's a pretty good result, I've got to say. For the Necro. I wonder if they'll try and secure the ball a little bit. He's very committed to the line. No, he's going straight into the punches. Gary Glitter loves it up the shitter. Starts off with a push. I guess actually he would have preferred the ball. Oh, here's a one die block. Ron Jeremy showing what he's made of. Spunking in the face of Doughface. Doughface. Stuns him. Doughfaced. He packs quite a punch, that Ron Jeremy, for an ugly, fat little fucker. And that's what she said. Needs to be careful here. Jimmy Savile. Just a push. All right. We've got a zombie free on the line. We might see him retreat slightly. Just to offer it. No! Ewan the Stiff. Comes up with a injury, smashed collarbone. And the Apo comes straight out of the benches onto the pitch. And that Thrall is fucked. He has smashed his collarbone and he is out. He's out of the game. Here comes another block. Again, just a push. Rerolled. Oh my word. He really wants to try and put the boot in. Ooh, brains. Puts your ex-girlfriend on his bottom. No harm done. Surely we've got to see an attempted ball pickup sooner rather than later. We've still got a blitz to come. Here comes Harvey. Oh my God. Harvey Weinstein. You fucking asshole. He had sure hands. He needed a three or better. He rolled a one and a two, I think. Oh. Yeah. Here's the first bloodlust of the game. It's Snide colleague. Gonna just take a nibble on stacked in. Is it? stacked in bad relations. Oh well, my word, we could have turnover of possession as early as turn one here, ladies and gentlemen. My bet's on your wife's stupid BFF agility 5 vampire running in, picking that ball up, dodging out, fucking just sitting back a little bit. Does he risk doing that now? Another bloodlust. My word, these vampires are fucking thirsty. Jesus Christ. Going for the hypnotic gaze, fails. He's going to have a chomp on somebody. What's going to happen to him? Another stun. Henpecked is stunned. Can't afford too many more of these bloodlusts, my word. Getting them all out the way early, perhaps. Your ex-girlfriend stands up with no problem. Comes a thrall block. Sissy. Armor value 6. Puts Quintus the Horrible on his ass. Hypochondriac employee just moves to... Here we go. Ball is retrieved. And the dodge out is successful. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. Your wife's stupid BFF. Agility 5 block vampire is now in possession of the ball on the necromantic drive. Well, Jawa Knight is going to be furious with his team. To be fair, it was the kick and it was Harvey Weinstein. Those two things in combination might have fucked this whole game up. I say might because there's a hell of a long way to go. Thank you. G'day, the past dog. Welcome to the chat. Good to see you here, mate. Good luck all, he says. Blood Bowl will be the winner tonight. 100%. Here goes Shit Cunt. Moving out to the left. Flesh Golem's doing what Flesh Golems do and try and get in the way. Michael Jackson, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is... I don't think it's an advisable... Well, he's already done his blitz anyway, I've just noticed, so... Jawa Knight is resigned to the fact that his game plan has now changed significantly from attack to defense in the blink of an eye. And he's now going to hope to try and turn the ball over again at some stage during this half. And to be honest, ladies and gentlemen, at this stage, a 0-0 half-time scoreline would be a success for the Necro, I've got to say. Right, Vamps, one thrall down. He's not coming back. That means 5 vampires, 5 thralls, 1 for each vampire. 4 rerolls in hand. Don't forget. Oh, here comes that Hypno Gaze. Necro do have a wizard up their sleeve. We may see that come into play this half. Jimmy Savile's going down, and he's stunned. Well, a 10 was needed on the armor roll, and a 10 is what he got. Comes the blitz. Oh, your crazy mother-in-law. Smacking Ron Jeremy, who was hypno-gazed. He had no idea what the fuck was going on. Vampire's just trying to get some kind of a cage in place, but they're a little bit tied up at the moment. Dodge. And a punch. Hypochondriac employee going to work. For once. And that would be turn 2 over. Turn 3, Necro. Vampire's just trying to stay away from these werewolves, I think. Very wary of their movement, 8. No dodge on this agility 5 vampire, but he does have block. There goes Shit Cunt, round the back. Harvey looking very sheepish, just fucking plodding around in the backfield. Very embarrassed from his turn 1 fuck up, as he should be. Alright, Gary Glitter loves it up the shitter. All he can do is push yet again. Does love to push, that Gary Glitter. He loves to push. right, looks like we're going to try and see Ron Jeremy get to his feet, maybe with a blitz action. Spineless the Thrall does have wrestle. Okay, well, there goes Michael Jackson going into base contact with your ex-girlfriend. Here's the blitz. The blitz is good. Thank you to Drexel, the tackle white. No harm done to your ex-girlfriend. And still no way through to the ball carrier. So Drexel retreats. And big boy Ron Jeremy gets to his feet. Another loner armor break here, just resulting in a stun. It's pretty lucky. Armor 6 got through the armor. Could only manage a roll of 6 on the injury table. Right. Necro just trying to bog the vampires down at this stage. Oh, okay. Wrestle coming into effect there. We might see a bit of movement. Towards the halfway line. The vampires still don't have enough players free to form an effective cage, though. Snide colleague going for shit cunt the werewolf. Gets him down, but no harm done. If I was the vampires, I'd probably take a hit on Michael Jackson. I know he's blodge, but you never know, you might roll that magical pow. Oh, no, we're going with a... Yep, a dodge. Hypno gaze attempt. Successful. Okay, now we might see progression. We've got Gep down the pitch here. This is what I mean about Hedgehog and his vampires. He sees these hypno gaze moves that I just don't even think about. Here comes the blitz. It's on Harvey. Push with the dodge skill coming into effect. Spinning roundhouse kick from hypochondriac. That's the one. It's like Hedgehog is thinking of going for it here. I've only got movement 6, these guys, so he can't. He can't quite get to safety. Maybe he will retreat. He is retreating. Trying to keep that ball safe. What does your crazy mother-in-law do? Oh, he decides he wants to fucking feed on something. Which is a little bit unfortunate, being the last action of the turn. He's decided to move somewhere where he cannot feed. And then changed his mind! Went the other way! Oh my word. The ball's on this guy. No surprises. Hedgehog taking the full 2 minutes there to take his turn. There's a lot to think about with these vampires in terms of where you place your thralls, where you move your vampires, where you employ your hypnotic gaze. Necro very much on the defensive. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. The problem that they've got is, even if one of these werewolves can reach the vampiric ball carrier, they have a strength problem. They're strength 3. Vampires are strength 4. Ball carrier also has block. So Michael Jackson opts to go the other way. So it is going to be somewhat difficult to apply pressure to the ball carrier. We might see Drexel, Taxel White, head down the pitch. Gary Glitter loves it up the shitter, puts Stacked in Bad Relations on his butt seeing stars. We're going vampire hunting by the looks of it. Got him. But he's fine. No players available for a sneaky foul. Which is a little bit unfortunate because he would have 3 assists. Jawa just solely focused on trying to prevent this touchdown from the vampires. Good game. I feel like Snide Colleague needs to get into the game a little bit more. He's isolated over on the left-hand side. If he's going to score, he's going to need to have all his vampires, I think, working in unison. Still got 4 rerolls, and the wizard is still in play. In fact, that might be an option for Jawa. Hit the lightning bolt button if this ball carrier stays deep. If there's a werewolf nearby, it can hopefully capitalize, tie everybody else up as much as possible. It's a tricky one in this situation for Jawa, when to use that wizard. Ooh, dodge blitz. Going for shit cunt, gets him down, but he's fine, no armor break. We're gonna see, I thought we might see a bit of a sideline cage there, no, but a cheeky GFI from your ex-girlfriend ties up one of those pesky journeyman zombies. Another successful dodge from the vampires. Alright, where's the ball going? Where is the ball going? I think we might see a pass action here. Your wife's stupid BFF. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, he's only got a few seconds left. Yep, here we go. Oh, beautiful pass that was. Oh, your snide colleague fails the dodge. It's re-rolled. Yeah, and that's what I was saying. He's back in the game with a GFI to boot. well. We have a potential blitz on our hands. May only be a one die. We could see Brains moving into a supporting position. We may see a Harvey Weinstein blitz. Joe and Ike would dearly love for Drexel with his tackle skill to have a pop instead, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Chances of that aren't great. He's tied up by Doe-Faced, the thrall. Jeremy's free. Here comes Shit Cunt around the back. Oh, and he fails a GFI with a roll of a one. That's got to be rerolled. And it is. Oh, my word. And it's fucking failed. Unbelievable. What a shit cunt. That's, again, that is, you can't legislate for that. Roll of a one. Rerolled into a six. And then another one. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. The people in chat agreeing, that is rough. Oof. Vampires seem to be behaving themselves in terms of bloodlust now that initial thirst has been quenched. The crazy mother-in-law still in possession of the ball. Need to be wary of Drexel. Lima's saying still not a guaranteed vamp score though. Field positioning's better for Necro. That is a push on Harvey. This is looking pretty solid from the Vampires. If they can, well, they've got the rerolls to deal with Bloodlust. They can move Snide Colleague down. But they can't complete the cage easily. There goes Snide Colleague. Going out wide. Lima with, I mean, I really don't think anything's guaranteed with Vampires. Nice dodge there from the thrall, and there we have it. A pretty much completed cage. That was a huge move there from, was that Doe-Faced? No, it was Sissy. And another 3+ dodge. Okay, this is looking pretty solid now for the Vampires. 3+ dodges help a great deal. And he pulls one more off. If you'll pardon the expression. And this is now very difficult for Necro to recover. Nice work, Hedgie. Here comes the wizard. It's a fireball. The wizard has been used. It was a fireball. And one vampire down. Out of a possible 1, 2, 3, 4 players. That is a very, very disappointing result for Jawa Knight. Does it present an opening for him? I just the strength four for me is the killer here. He will try his best. Turn six wizard. Terrible result. Lima's suggestion is tie up the cage and get Harvey and the Tucker White back. Get them back in the game. Gary Glitter loved it up the shitter, putting another thrall on his ass. Might see some dodgy action from Michael Jackson here to try and get in front of this cage somewhere. We had a blitz yet? No, we have not. Oh, well, there goes the Tackle White. The whole left quadrant is free reign for these vampires to maraud into. Unless Michael Jackson can pull out a bit of moon dancing magic. Moonwalking dancing magic. You know, like Thriller style. Here he goes, here comes the blitz. Okay, so he's gone for what your wife's stupid BFF. He's got her. And he's got a tackle zone on the ball. He can get another one if he's quick. Get that zombie in there. No, he chooses to tie up one of the other vampires. And manages to get a final block in. Run Jeremy up there on his own. Alright, well, we've got a couple of free thralls that we can... Oh, there's the Bloodlust. Is that the ball carrier, your ex-girlfriend? It is. No, it's not. Okay, yep. Your ex-girlfriend running in circles, trying to find somebody to fucking have a nibble on. Oh, no, he's changed his mind again. This is fucking craziness. Oh. Why would you choose Sissy? He's armor six. Bradley hurt off the pitch. Two thralls not coming back. Whoa, I'm missing it. Okay, we've got a lot of movement. Fuck, these vampires dodging like they're some kind of elves. Not high elves, of course. I do enjoy Jawa Knight's memes. No, oh, armor value doesn't matter in feeds. Thank you, Lima. Thank you for constantly correcting me. Straight to injury. Thank you, sir. Alright, have we got a wolf? We've got two wolves, but... 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they're too far away. This ball is too well protected. The Vampires have done a sterling job. Cheers, Lever. Haven't seen a huge amount of the Hypno Gaze. He hasn't really needed them. Jawanite will be hoping for a similar piece of misfortune that occurred to him on turn one. Comes to Blitz. Blitz is good. Agility 5 Vampire. Fine. Don't think they're going to be stopping this touchdown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're seeing a foul action. Oh, I think we are, you know. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a GFI from whoever that is, Brains. And he's failed it. Of course he's failed it. He's re-rolling it. And here comes the spiky slipper! Oh! Got him! Injured! Your wife's stupid BFF is injured. Bradley hurt. Will she regen? Agility 5. Let's have a look. No! No, no, no! She doesn't. Brains is sent off. But he won't give a fuck about that. He's just Bradley hurt. An agility 5 Vampire. Well, that may well. Surely we're not farming SPP at this stage. Okay, we are. We've got a failed pass. Does he catch it? Does. Snide colleague scores. Fuck, you gotta hand it to these vampires. They are crazy motherfuckers, are they not? Farming SBP in the bowl final. I've seen it all now. Hedgehog, for your benefit, Lima has said in the chat, fucking showboating in a grand final. That's 10 lashings. 10. Fucking hell. So, we're 2 thralls and a vampire down. One zombie out for the Necro. The Necro have the numbers. They've got the wolves. They've still got Harvey. Can he redeem himself? Jawanite, you're being called out, I'm afraid, mate. Lima's saying, no Necro one turn touchdown. Soft. S-O-F-T. Well, it's a great catch, Harvey. Shame you couldn't do that turn one, mate. I'm being a bit harsh there. He was nowhere near the ball to catch it turn one. But yes, Lieber's quite right. High kick and a catch. would have been most handy for a one-turn touchdown attempt. You've got your movement 8 / movement 10. According to Bubba Tattoo's rules, werewolves. It's 3 pushes you would have needed. Instead, we're thrall fouling. If you're gonna do it, make sure you get through the fucking armor with as many assists as you possibly can. Good lad. It's just a stun though. One more turn to come for the vampires. Finish off the half. I would not be surprised if they just stood there and did fuck all. Why risk the bloodlust? I guess you've got to reroll, but snake eyes is a thing. Having a think about it. Decides to do fuck all. 1-0. Emotional vampires. Against the runner play. Does he get his KO back? He does not. So 4 players short. Necro definitely have the numbers. What have we got? 4 vampires, 3 thralls, 4 rerolls. Wizard has been used. This, ladies and gentlemen, is most definitely game on. Don't know if I'd keep my wolves back. I think I'd put them somewhere a bit closer to the line. Take a risk. See if you can take advantage of their movement. And get in and around the ball. First thing you need to do, this very first turn of the second half, is pressure the fucking shit out of the ball. Can't just rely on these vampires rolling bloodlusts. Right, what's going to happen? Hedgehog thinking about who's going to make this kick. Sorry. Jawa. It's Jawa kicking. It's a high kick. Oh, and the ball is caught with a roll of a 6. Well, there is a bloodlust failed, re-rolled into a failed bloodlust. I think we're going to see Snide Colleague leaving the pitch. He spotted somebody in the crowd. Maybe it was that babe that he brought. But he's off for a fucking nibble and we're not going to see him. So, vampires now down to... Shit. 6 players. 3 vamps, 3 thralls. And that's a turnover. Now, if Jawa had a werewolf handy, he could apply a significant amount of pressure on the ball carrier. Hedgehog down to three rerolls. If your ex-girlfriend plays the cards right, she can just fuck around in her own side of the pitch. Not really, doesn't even really have to move. Surely we're going to see some action from these werewolves. Heading down towards the ball. Lima, would you have blocked or changed to dodge and feed Brog? Yeah, good question. Because you can change your action, can't you? It would have to be the dodge and feed. Why block and get sent off? Now, okay, this might be good play from Jawa. He's choosing to man mark as opposed to getting as close as he can to the ball carrier. Even using the ghoul Harvey Weinstein to man mark. Take advantage of that stunned hypochondriac employee. Here comes another foul. It's on your crazy mother-in-law. Dodge vampire. Just stun. But a stun is very nice. Netcaro can crank the pressure up next turn. Where the fuck do the vampires go? What the fuck do they do? They've got four active players, one of which is a vampire, three are thralls, all of them are tied up apart from the ball carrier. This is difficult now for Hedgehog. He's going with the ball carrier blitz. So GFI, he's re-rolled it, it's a push. He would have hoped for a knockdown there. Didn't get it. I've got to say, the ball is in jeopardy. Hedgehog, you're now getting 20 lashings for not changing that block action to a move action. For that previous bloodlust. Just letting you know. Loves his lashings, doesn't he? That Lima. Ooh. Where's your Taka White when you need him? He's on the wrong side of the pitch. Strength 4 Blodge. It's not going to be easy to get the ball. It's not going to be easy. Oh, well, there's a handy 3 plus dodge. Okay, Lima, too much information. If lockdown has taught me anything, it's that lashings are great. Okay. What can Michael Jackson do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... You can get around there somewhere. Maybe think about... Oh, you need Harvey over by the ball somewhere. Not just marking a downed vampire. but that's what he's got. Well, here's the blitz. Blitz is good. No armor break. We'll make base contact with the ball carrier. Necro now looking to base up whoever else is loose. Harvey makes his move of one square. He goes Wacko Jacko. Yep, okay, doubling up on... Oh, shit cunt. Gets a pow. Oh, armor break, but it's just a stun. But look, with only six players on the pitch, even a stun is fucking gold. Oh, my word. Literally putting the boot in now, the Necro. And we've got a Vampire KO. They are down to five players. And that's a sending off for the Necro, but they won't mind too much. So what's that? Necro down to nine. Vampires down to five. Here goes the ball. Is he just gonna... What's he gonna do? Is he gonna throw it? No. He's gonna rely on his strength four and his blodge. Oh, wow. Okay, all right. Tying up the tackle white. Fails a hypno gaze. And only one player left to move. It's the blitz. Oh, wow. Okay. Spineless. Showing that he's anything but. Can now move to protect the ball a little bit. This is superb. Absolutely superb play from the Vampires. With limited numbers on the pitch. We've seen it before during this particular season. And we're seeing it again here in action tonight. Yeah, get some fucking wolves around the... Okay, alright, well. Strength four, you see. That's your problem. You feel like you've got to commit two assists to try and hit them. But in actual fact, well, it's easy to say, but your best bet might be to ignore them. But of course you ignore them, they've got agility four as well, they can just fucking catch a fluky pass and fuck off down the pitch. So Drexel looking to put the hurt on the hypochondriac employee. Harvey making a move around the back. Sneaky little cunt that he is. On Jeremy. Are we gonna see Jimmy Savile? Oh, okay. Well, hypochondriac employee's going down. He's fine. And this will be the blitz from Jimmy Savile. What's he got in his locker? It'll be a one die against Blodge. Or does he just tie him up? Does he forego the blitz? Might as well blitz. He's not blitzing. He's just looking to tie him up. Heaps of fucking time left in this game. I think it's a one die blitz, it's a push. Stand firm, says fuck you, I ain't going nowhere. Yeah, I was just going to say, Lima. Oh my god. 3 plus 2 plus. Dodgers made with a rolls of 3 and a 4. And a GFI. And he's going to go again. He's not making it easy. You've got to take your hat off. I'm starting to think that Hedgehog is actually a vampire. I think I'm with Blake. So I think whether these KOs come back or not, Lima, to me, might determine. Well, one, two, three, four, five, six. Must be able to get. No, he can't. Really needs to get his tackle white free and onto the ball carrier. Oh, this is some play by the vampires. Tackle white blitz has to. 1, 2, 3, 4. Putting that fucking annoying spineless thrall in the way. Yeah. Shit cunt goes into support. Gary Glitter loves it up the shitter. Ties up spineless. He needs the ball, and he needs the ball now. Where's Harvey going? He's going in support as well. Oh, with a dodge. All right. We're going to see a Michael Jackson special coming any minute now. Here he comes. And he's got it. Exactly what he needed. And shit cunt pulls off the catch of the game, 4+, rolls a 4. Wow. Absolute beauty. Oh well, don't go anywhere, anyone. This is going to overtime. Which, considering we're in a grand final, wow, this could be big. No. He's fine. Mm-hmm. How many turns has Hedgehog had five players for? It's got to be at least two turns. Oh, optimistic. Okay, well, he's got a push. He's used a reroll. That may come back to haunt him. Three rerolls in hand for the Necro. Now in base contact with the ball carrier. Here comes the blitz. Oh, shit, it's good. Shit, cunt. The ball carrying werewolf is Bradley hurt. Does he regen? He does not regenerate. And the ball is loose. And the dodge is failed. By your ex-girlfriend. And she is stunned. All action here, people. It's all fucking on like Donkey Kong. Smoke to bong. Got a little bit high and put on a thong. Michael Jackson taking down Spineless. No, wrestle. Okay, this is Harvey's moment to redeem himself. All he needs to do is pick up the ball. And he does. Well done, Harvey. Don't listen to everybody else, mate. You're okay in my book. Don't listen to the haters. Haters gonna hate. Plenty of turns left. Necro would be wise to take care of these two thralls in the backfield. Yep. Okay, got one. Does he break armor? Does. And injured. Beautiful. He's got a hit on the other one. Just a push. Now, Drexel, do you protect the ball or do you mark up Hypochondriac employee? Chooses to protect the ball. Harvey does have Blodge. I believe that will be a one die and a GFI. Doesn't go for it. Is he going to hypno gaze? He does, but it fails. He needed that to succeed. Here comes a blitz anyway. Oh my word. It's a one die block and it's a pow and the ball is again loose. Harvey is stunned. Fucking hell, Spineless. What a game he is having this evening. And another 3+ dodge. The vampires are not lying down. Harvey has had an absolute shocker. Couldn't agree more, Lima. Fuck The Necro are running out of time. They've got this turn and two others. And they're one more werewolf down. Harvey's down, stunned. Michael Jackson needs to save this game for the Necro. Otherwise, it's fucking all over Rover. And they've just pushed a Thrall into base contact with the ball. Can they get him down? Get Wacko Jacko up first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think the Necro are fucking struggling here. I really think they're struggling. A, to get the ball. And B, to fucking score. A pal helps. Spineless. Hits the deck. His armor's fine. Oh! Drexel tries to dodge on a 3 plus. He fails with the 2 re-rolls. But fails the pickup. Well, fucking hell, there goes fucking hypochondriac employee, hypno gazers. The vampire's going to retrieve the ball here. Unbelievable play from the vampires, unbelievable. Four fucking players left on the pitch. Comes the blitz. Oh! Fails the GFI. Rerolls. Oh, that's no good. That's no good for your ex-girlfriend. He didn't want that. Michael Jackson stays on his feet. Pause. What the fuck is Spineless gonna do? I reckon he's gonna try and pick the fucking ball up, and he is! No? Is he gonna GFI it? He's not. Oh, Jesus Christ. I almost shat myself. Ah, yes, Lima. Oh. Two turns. Fucking shitload of... I don't think Necro can do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They can't score unless 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this fucker could do it. Ron Jeremy. We might see a zombie. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1 GFI, but the fucker needs to catch the ball. Okay, Harvey's in possession and he's failed another dodge. Oh, fucking gets out that time. Hands off to Ron Jeremy. Ron Jeremy's off down the pitch. Is he going to throw it? Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He needs 4 GFIs to score himself. What the fuck is he going to do? What do you do? What do you do? You got 2 rerolls. He's not going to pass it. He's going to go for GFIs. 2 GFIs this turn. You need to GFI it. Count the squares, bro. He's failed the first one. Okay. He's made the two. Oh, 2, 4, 6, 8. Oh, shit. I can't fucking cope. I can't cope. Fucking hell. This is such a good final. I've got to say, well played, both coaches. Jarl and I, you haven't given up at any stage. You've kept going. What can that thrall at the back do? Oh, fuck, I forgot about him. Here he goes. Fails his dodge. No rerolls left. All right, Ron, you've got one thing to do and one thing only. Score a fucking touchdown. Take us to overtime. Do it. Do it. It's a tree strip wired it. Reroll. Yes. Fucking Jesus. Jesus, Harold Christ. What a game. No rerolls left. What? Does Hedgehog get any KOs back? Why has my screen gone black? Okay. He gets a vampire back. Who's going to win the toss? Oh, looks like vampires have won the toss. 0 re-roll over time. Welcome to the chat, Bowen. How are you, mate? Oh, fucking hell. Right. Player count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the vampires. 4 of which are vampires. No rerolls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for the necro. 1 wolf. 1 tackle white. Shorehands blodge ghoul. Fuck, you tell me. You tell me, chat. It's fucking anybody's game in my book. If the vampires keep a 1 away from the dice, it could be theirs. If they don't, it could be the necro. I think it's as simple as that. Pardon me. And correct me if I'm wrong, Lima, but overtime is sudden death. So, first team to score wins. Here's the kick. Vampires get a fucking reroll. Yep, we're in sudden death. Golden goal territory. Lima's saying that reroll is huge. Huge! Fucking hell. Okay, the thralls are the first to move. Snide colleague moves to the left, down the wing, within scoring distance. Hypochondriac employee does the same on the other side of the pitch, within scoring distance. GFIs are required. Here comes a blitz. Your crazy mother-in-law. Blitzing Ron Jeremy, just resulting in a push. Your ex-girlfriend. Okay, no bloodlust this turn. Surely going to sit tight here behind these couple of thralls. Fucking Necro, you got some decisions to make now. Do you attack the ball? Do you mark up the vamps? I think the answer to our question comes in the form of brains. We're marking up vamps. Really is a fantastic game of Blood Bowl. Okay, so Drexel chooses not to blitz. Would have been tempted to have blitzed the dodge vampire there. But the blitz will be coming from Wacko Jacko, Michael Jackson, after the loner zombie has put himself into position. Oh, got him. But he's fine. Well. Necro playing it patiently. Trying to get the vampires to roll some dice. This is very, very good strategy from Jawa. Thralls to move first. One re-roll in hand for the Vamps. The ball is moved safely with no bloodlust rolled. What do these other fuckers do? They're almost on the halfway line. Here comes a dodge. Oh! Double ones! Double ones, it's a failed re... It's a failed dodge and a turnover. Get tackle on the dodge would be my suggestion. Yeah, I possibly would have tried to put him right here. But that's okay. That should stop him. Here comes the blitz. Blitz is good on Snide colleague. Michael Jackson trying his claw. Gets a KO. That is also huge. Necro can now afford to be a little bit more progressive. Apply a little bit more pressure. But still being ultra, ultra cautious. Just trying to whittle the numbers right down till there's only a couple of players left before making their move. Oh, here comes a foul. I like this. I like this. Just a stun. Unlucky, Jawa Knight. Unlucky. It's a good move, that. Fuck. A stun helps, though, eh? And the vampires retreat. Trying to preserve their numbers. Oh no, we're not gonna go to a kickoff, are we? Ooh, that bloodlust was close. Over to you, JK. Turn 19 of 24. 6 or 7 turns left. We've got two vampires to keep an eye on in the backfield, both on their back. I think we're just going to see another foul here. Is Jawa Knight playing this too cautiously? Is my question. Comes a foul. Oh no! Passive removal for the vampires. Another stun and another sending off. That's three sendings off this game for the Necro. Fucking hell. Here's a question for you, Lima. Can you blitz and hypno gaze in the same action? Don't believe you can. Here comes the blitz. Oh, blitz is good. And all of a sudden, Ron Jeremy. No, hypochondriac employee is free. Free and easy. Can your crazy mother-in-law survive another foul, if indeed That is what Jawa Knight decides to do. He's already had three sendings off. Is the ref really that fucking biased and corrupt? I guess we fucking know the answer, don't we? And they still refuse to apply pressure to the ball carrier. Almost seemingly happy to take this to an extra time kickoff. Oh, but we've got a vampire injury. Hypochondriac employee is injured. Fractured his leg. Regens, but I don't know whether that's going to do Hedgehog any good. Four players left on the pitch for the vampires. Here comes a foul! And another stun! Holy shit balls! Alright. That's it, JK. Let's see some movement towards the ball. Not as much as I would have liked, but at least it's some. Holy fuck. We've still got Harvey on the pitch. We've still got Wacko Jacko on the pitch. We've still got Tackle on the pitch. Alright, vampires deciding they just need to fucking go for this. Two red dice. It's a push. Alright. This is a fucking very ballsy play by the vampires. Your ex-girlfriend, now is not the time to roll a bloodlust! It's re-rolled. Fucking hell! Oh, no! No, he's lost the ball! He's lost the ball, he failed his bloodlust, he re-rolled the bloodlust, and then he failed a GFI, my fucking god! Oh! Harvey can smell blood, heads towards the ball, but goes into base contact. Surely we're not going to try a werewolf pickup, are we? With no rerolls. Four turns, including this one left. Here's the blitz. Blitz is good. Stacked in bad relations. Does he survive? Yes, he does. Here goes Wacko Jacko. He's going for the ball. He's got it. He's fucking got it on a 3+. He rolls a 4. He runs away, wagging his tail. Oh, he's a very fucking happy bunny. Look at him. Yeah, look at me. Look at me. Oh, I've got the ball. Oh, Bowen saying it mustn't be a necro win now. Oh no, ex-girlfriend has fucked it all up. Gone for a GFI blitz, failed the GFI and got herself K the fuck owed. And it is going to be a necro win. It is going to be a necro win. It is going to be a necro win. Oh, what a game. Oh, just a great game, Bowen. Both teams. Yeah, 100% by the Vamps. Low on players. Well played, Necro. Well played, Jawa. He was patient. He stuck at it. Bided his time. And in turn 23... is still throwing blocks. Oh, God. Run the ball in. Run the ball in. Here he goes, Wacko Jacko takes the long way round, puts it under the posts. Victory! Doing it doggy style! Don't even bother, Bowl. Season 7 winners. Congratulations and well done. My word. That, ladies and gentlemen, was a fucking fantastic game. Really, really good. Such good play by both coaches. Hedgehog for keeping the threat going. JK. Hedgehog.
Bro,
where on earth do I start?
Fuck the dice rolls.
Oh, he's mourning now about dice. See him, but yeah, honestly, tell all you unlucky dice you have got. Like, yeah, the only chance is go to the extra time. Yeah. It was because of your dice on the first half.
Oh yeah, it made it interesting. The 150k I spent on the wizard, well worth it.
Yeah, absolutely not. The one of the worst fireballs I've seen in living history. I was thinking, I was wondering, you know, early in that first half when the vampires turned the ball over and then they went deep in their own half, I was wondering whether you might consider the lightning bolt. If you could get a werewolf close, but it was getting players close to it, I think, was the issue.
And I've played Hedgehog a few games now, and I know that he likes to keep one player back or two players, and he likes to spread your team out. and I realized I was getting my team spread out again.
Yeah.
And I've tried rushing his ball carrier in the back, and I've lost every time.
Yeah, yeah.
So my plan was,
because we were all calling for that, of course. We were saying, apply pressure, but nah, I applaud your patience. It really paid off. Well played.
Yeah, it doesn't work. Yeah, nice. Anyone else, I will rush her. Not Hedgie. I've got too much respect of how he plays that.
But, oh, thanks.
You've rung me so many times where I'm like, chase, chase, chase. Oh, God, because he'll do two go for it, two dodges, a pass, and then another dodge.
And then they're gone. Yeah.
You're like, yeah. That's why I switched to the fouling tactic.
Yeah,
it's worked. I start panic, like, I should keep, staying there. But, when I didn't have players anymore, I thought, what I can do.
And look, even without removals, with four or five players on the pitch, a stun is gold, right?
It is. Yeah. And I think I had two stunned vampires out of five for turn after turn. And that's the conversation Hedgie and I were having. I was like, if you don't move, I'm just going to keep kicking them. I'm going to kick them and kick them until you get out or I get fouled out. And I just got lucky.
Yeah.
I just was staying and I waiting. I just need two vamps, get out of stunned.
Yeah.
And your team, because my vamps was on one side, so you swing a bit. And if this moment I will have luck and my vamps won't be stunned, I just will rush on the left side and I will try to dodge them out and do some numbers on the left side.
Yeah.
So you will struggle to get there. So I will have chance to just dodge out and pass, but it's never happened. They always was stunned.
I had enough. I was teaming up with four players to guarantee those fouls.
Yeah.
And or blitzing with my werewolf, so you're only armless, you know, only need to roll eight to get to you. Here's what I'm bitching about my dice rolls, but that's pretty much just the first half. Like, I knew halfway through the first half, I'm like, it's pretty much the fireball, and he's one dice block on my blitz on my blodging.
On Harvey.
That's when I just lost and went fouling.
Oh,
I
mate.
Fuck yeah.
Harvey had the worst fucking game I've ever seen him play.
Season.
Absolute shit cunt he is.
Season. He's dropped the ball.
He restored himself in the second half and especially in extra. Did he?
No, he didn't do nothing. He literally sat there and went, kick him in the bus.
Yeah.
He dropped the ball in the first half. Got blitzed on the at the end of the first half, and I managed to somehow get the ball. And I was just, Harvey's just been a fucking disappointment. And news report from TMZ, he's going to get sacked with the rest of the team.
Screw you, because he been your second, your first touchdown, because he pick up in tackle zone, dodge out, and get the handoff.
That's
so
because he
just. If without him you can't have it, just pick up in the tackle zone and dodge out. You know, it's not an easy.
No, but I mean, I
that
still
doesn't
failed.
Make it right.
No, I still had to use both inbuilt rerolls because he was so useless.
Hedgehog, did you actually enjoy the game?
Yeah, I was worried about Java in the first half. So I tried to do some crazy stuff, like pass for the first touchdown.
Yeah, you'll listen back to the commentary and you're getting 10 lashings from Lima for that, for showboating.
I didn't know he was watching, but I will. It just was for fun because, it was really ridiculous how the guys hit Java. And I made a mistake because the timer, and I left my vampire open, so he could have a dice on him, at least one.
Mm.
And he just decided to bring, more support and with Merful fail, go for it. And it was...
Well, I needed him to get the one die. That was the thing. If I got the werewolf there, I could send my white in to get a one die, and he had to tackle. So,
Ah, yeah, you want tackle, eh?
yeah. So I was happy to go for one die with a re-roll, with a tackle piece. So 33% chance, you know, two shots at it. Nope. The first four or five turns was just a series of comical errors on my behalf. So,
And Hedgehog,
but.
you've played Vamps for a bit now. Are you finding the time issue is a bit of a problem? Because there's a lot to think about with them, right? You need to think about where you want to place your thralls before you move your vampires. You've got to think about Hypnogaze, where it might be best to play it. Is the timer causing an issue or
Yeah,
not?
still not as much as before, like, and I managed finished 80% of my turns in time, but
I
yes.
think you only had one turn where you just went, "Oh crap, I've only got 5 seconds." But you did well. Oh,
Oh,
like I said,
thanks.
for most of the vamp stuff, I got lucky, but the hypno gaze really wasn't a factor.
Ah, yeah.
Like I think they failed. Actually, I can tell you how many times they failed. I've got it up here. Because that was what I was worried about. I was worried about the mass. I couldn't screen him. Hypno gaze. Here we go. Success 3, failure 5.
Yeah.
And I think that was a factor for me just getting back into the
37%.
game.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first half was fantastic by Hedgie. Like take the dice out, he just played it so much better.
Yeah,
But
and I think the numbers counted in the end. You got those removals that you needed,
yeah,
and when after you've got those removals, you got the stuns and you played the
that's
long
it.
game, and we all everybody watching really applauds you for that. Well done, mate. And look, you're both an absolute credit to the league, the way that you played this game, and also just the way that you've treated each other, and it's awesome. It's awesome to watch.
Oh no, look,
Oh, it's
Hedgehog and
so
I enjoy playing each other, but I have a
great.
lot of fun playing against Hedgehog, so.
Yeah. Yeah, the same. But it's a bit stressful against Java. He's too good coach. But yeah, I'm
Yeah,
enjoying
well,
it. A bit
you
modest.
don't have to worry too much because he's only bringing wood elves next season. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like in his hand, the wood elves will be like dangerous.
Yeah, I was being sarcastic.
All right, I see.
He's got an agility 6 war dancer,
He
which,
told me.
you know.
I think it may be going to miss next season.
I think he's going to get fouled 16 turns in a row.
Yeah, I think JK next season we might introduce some kind of a bounty scheme,
I
just for
like him
him.
because I'm pretty certain I'll kill him on a leap before any of you get to him.
Yeah, normally how it happens, I think.
It's a go for it or a leap. I'm going to break his own neck. So,
Yeah, it's pretty much it, I think.
just make sure you have got APO and you have got another APO as inducements.
Look, like I said, I'm going to try and play 150, 100k down so I can get a second apothecary just for him.
Yeah, exactly.
But
But
hey,
yes, my. Ah.
that's next season. This season
It
is
is.
still going. Congratulations, Jawa Knight. You are
Thank
the
you.
Don't Even Bother Bowl
Yay!
winner. We still got sloppy
Congratulations.
seconds and Show Pony Grand Finals to come, so thanks for watching, everyone.
And
And
thank you very much for the commentary,
yeah,
by the
no
way. Yeah,
worries,
thanks,
mate.
Brock, for the commentary.
No worries at all, gents. Anytime.
I'll watch it back tomorrow while I'm not as stressed out.
Yeah.
I will do good win, Java. Good
No, no. Thank you very much, and thank you for the game.
Good stuff,
win.
guys.
Thank you.
All right, guys. Take care, everyone.
See you later.